What's going on, guys? Your boy Real Deal Akil back again with another video. I'm parked right now at my barber. Well, I'm not inside yet, but I'm about to get a haircut because, you know, your boy needs it. I've been wearing my do-rag all day, but if I don't wear it, my hair in the back, it doesn't stay flat how it's supposed to. It'll start coming up, and then the hair in the back, instead of being wavy and flat, it starts poking out and it starts becoming curly. So I gotta get this taken care of. So we about to walk up in there now. I think y'all met my barber before in one of my previous videos. When we were out here and he had like a little, not barbecue, but kind of like a little event right here, right outside the shop. And so about to go in here, about to get this cut, you know. Have a conversation with my guy and, you know, get chopped up while doing it. So, you know, be sure to like the video, comment, and subscribe for more. I'll be back once I get inside the barbershop. I'm in a chair right now, in the middle of it. Got the news on right now. I guess it's a pretty big thunderstorm coming up. Man goes broken right there. This is the man. I know I had a video with him in it before when you had the event in the parking lot over there back in, was that earlier last year?
August.
Yeah, August. Yeah. Everything good? How you been?
Great, man. I can't complain, bro. I can't do a whole other level, man. A whole other level of things, man. Bigger and better things.
Yeah.
I'm trying to elevate, you know?
Yeah. Hey.
Same thing I was talking about over here. We have to elevate.
Yeah. You know, me and Brooklyn, we'll be having some good talks, man. Every time, you know.
Another good one right now, too.
Oh, yeah, it's about to be another good one, man. This is a guy that gets me right. I'll be sure to leave his Instagram in the link below, you know. Because if you're in the area, you got to come see this man. Because I know y'all be seeing me, like, every time. That's because of him.
You don't even got to be in the area. Just come
through. Yeah, just, hey, just come through just because. Just because you need a cut. No matter where you at, just come.
I got a chance to meet Kyrie on Sunday, man.
Oh, you did? Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah. It's a game, and Sham introduced me to him, so I'm trying to be him next, be in his chair, too, as well.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Oh, yeah, he cuts Lucas' hair. So, you know, that'd be another one, another client. But what do you think about that? How do you think that, I know it's going to take some time for them to gel, Kyrie and Luca, but.
Real players, they're finding their way, man. He thinks they need the role players, even though they're role. Those two guys, they need some things. It's 1A, 1A, and 1B.
Yeah.
Really, actually, both alpha males. Whoever gets the ball, whoever's high at the end of the game, that's probably the team win the shot. But by Luka already being here, that's probably 6 years, but his team, you know?
Oh, yeah, it's definitely Luka's team. And it'll always be Luka's team for as long as he's here. But I think they'll figure it out. But like you said, the role players got to figure it out. And then losing... traded Dorian Finney-Smith and Spencer Dinwiddie. Those were some good pieces for the Mavs, so.
He got one of the Morris twins over there, too. I saw him play, too. He got one of the Morris twins over there.
Oh, yeah. He's a knockdown shooter, too, so that'd be good.
More of an enforcer, too, to take the load off Luka a little bit. You go out there and get a groundwork. You know, Luka's got a problem getting a lot of technical fouls.
Yeah.
So they got this young fella in there, come in, get a bruiser.
Mm-hmm.
All he did is rob me.
Yeah, that's one thing. Yeah, Luka do that. He does get a lot of technical fouls. So we'll see. I think it'll work out. Just got to get more games in together. And the games they've lost, they've been close. They've been up in the air. They've been 50-50. So they'll get it together. And then once the role players start doing what they got to do, Luka and Kyrie figure out how to play, which they already know somewhat.
I'm surprised that they even lost a game. They were about 27.
Oh, they were?
The game up. The Lakers came all the way back and took the game. And the Davis played the butt off.
Oh, yeah. I watched that. Yeah.
He got busy.
Yeah, he did. He did. I know they lost to the Pacers. Was it yesterday?
They lost to the Pacers yesterday?
Yeah, they lost to the Pacers yesterday.
Oh, man. They only won one game since Kyrie been here.
I mean, it's still early, but, you know.
West, though, baby.
Yeah, that's true. It's so close right now between, like, the five and the... and the bottom seed, like 13, so yeah, you can't lose too many games. So what keeps you going, like what keeps you motivated, what keeps you doing the things that you want to do? I know you're big on elevating, we both are, but like what keeps you going? What's that drive that keeps you going?
Trying to have a purpose, trying to be better today than I was yesterday. You know, it's one thing that, you know, teach his own, but one thing, I'm self-motivating, man. You gotta make that happen, because if you don't move your feet, you know, you come from where I'm from, everybody trying to do some of the same things or similar things. So we have to set yourself apart and go get it. Got me having sons. I try to instill in them hard working determination type of mentality, attitude, so they'll see that dad was one of those hard, humble guys. He went up there and got it. He like love. He's self-made. I own my own business over 20 plus years. Been behind the chair, same as well, from sports to business world. I only got the degrees, got the transfer the right way. Now I'm making my next thing, getting your world, technology. That's my next goal, which is technology side.
So what do you think is like the best way to attack? Do you attack yours like your goals like one by one, like master one and get done and then move on to the next thing?
I don't, man. I'm multi-tag. I kind of work better with being under a microscope and having a lot of things on my plate.
Mm-hmm.
For example, just jump out there. I have an urge, I have an itch to be inspired by certain things. Once I get a tailwind, I light the wick, watch burn at the end, man, before I'm going full. You gotta jump out there, man. Try new things. That'll be different. Not be afraid to have new challenges. Play sports, man. Those things are always gonna be there for you.
Yeah.
I'm in a mindset.
That's true. I think, you know, sports is a good way for, especially at a young age, to learn those things. Deal with adversity. You know, teamwork, communication. Like, there's a lot of good life skills that we could take from
absolutely
from sports, especially at a young age, just playing. And,
absolutely, man. I failed way more times than people have seen me succeed.
Yeah.
Way more times. But those are just things that you have to go through. You got to try and get it right, especially if it's a new avenue for me that I've never tried it. I didn't know about the comedy at first. I just like stand-up comedy and I jumped out there.
Yeah.
My first show was a success to the people. To me, it wasn't.
Yeah.
Because I expected better. It was a great turnout, great show, but I saw my flaws. Going forward, I just added to it, kept going, getting better and bigger. And it's going to what it is right now. So another brand, another avenue, another lane.
I like what you said about you just got to put yourself out there, try new things. Like, can't be afraid to try new things, guys. Can't. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, it's just like, just think about it. The biggest people that you see, not even the biggest people, but even just successful people in general, they had to start from somewhere. And 9 times out of 10, they probably failed more times than they succeeded. So, like you said, so just about you can't be afraid to fail because it's definitely part of the process.
Some home runs in the first swing are very few, but they can't happen, don't get me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
If I hit a home run the first time, I wouldn't know, I wouldn't appreciate it as much as I did.
Yeah.
So when I go through my little bumps, my woes, I hit my imperfections, I'm going to be up and going from being down, so take it and run with it, man. It's a road coaster, bro.
Yeah. That's all it is. And it's just about how you sustain, you know, and stay consistent.
One key thing that puts you off is going to keep you going. It's how you treat people. How you treat people and their response like you. To give you the motivation, to give you the energy to keep going.
Yeah.
And somebody said, man, I appreciate you doing this. That was a great interview. That was a great conversation we had.
Mm-hmm.
And they sparked the interest. And you feel a sense of pride, then keep going. You want to do it for them again, get the same thing again.
Yeah.
It's a chase, man.
You're definitely right about that, because I'll even have, like, friends that will be like, yo, man, when you drop a new video, they'll tell me that they like my stuff or like the videos or whatever.
Right.
And it gives you, like, more of a reason to keep on doing what you're doing, you know?
That's
exactly, because that's you know, it's good to hear or have that positive feedback. And then, even though I don't get it a lot, but I appreciate the feedback that isn't so good, too, because it's like, that means I just got to work on some stuff, you know?
If you're so perfect, man, you would think you should get 1,000 likes, 100,000 likes on every video you put up.
Right, but exactly.
You got to go through, especially when you're doing it yourself. You self-taught, man. You wasn't taught by anybody else. You're supposed to get it wrong.
Yeah.
One thing ain't wrong. Ways, but it just got way
too big. Hey, I'll show you at the end of the video. That's the thing, too. It's just like, you know, just like with anything, like how you are cutting hair, it's a comedy, how I am with these YouTube videos, and then how I was repairing phones, just like with anything, like the more you do something, you're gonna get better at it naturally, just cause you're putting in the effort, you're putting in the work, and you're putting in the time to get better at
absolutely
it.
Absolutely. So I think we're gonna shop it too, man. We come in here one day and see us with a live podcast, doing this live from the shop, from the headquarters, and make that happen, man.
Oh yeah, that'd be big. That'd be nice. That'd
no,
be
I'm
nice.
Calling you out on camera about this. I need
you
to
call,
call you out.
Oh, you're calling me out on
it. Call you out on camera.
Hey, I'll be
now
here.
You gotta do that. Make that happen, be good. Thank you, bro.
Yeah, guys. You got to put yourself out there with everything. And, you know, and the good thing about trying stuff is it's not always just about, like, being a successful part, too. It's just, like, you find out what you don't want to do and what you do want to do. So it's like, you know, not everything is meant for everybody. So, you know, but just trying, you know what is for you and what isn't for you, you know? So,
well, I like your mindset on how you answer that question. It's a fact. You just say that, man, you're relatively young. You're a very young, young man, and you say things like that most people don't get so fast. They don't pick up on that.
Yeah.
You say that you're trying because a lot of people I deal with and talk to, you're not far removed from that age. If you saying that right now, it says a lot, man, about the person that you've grown into. I guarantee you wasn't that person in high school that you are right now.
Nah, I wasn't. Damn sure wasn't. And honestly, that I don't think that'd be a good thing if I was. You know?
Yeah, look at how you evolve.
Yeah.
You go through certain things and become the better person that you are right now. Sometimes adversity is a good thing.
For sure. And a lot of people may not see it like that. It's just like a hard time, but you know.
Because y'all think it's the end of the world. You feel like, if I can get through this, I can conquer anything.
Yeah.
I've had some of those days, man. Walls close in on me.
Yeah. And that's when you just gotta like double down, you know, gotta think. Because there's always a way when you want it.
Absolutely. Tighten that belt up. What's next for you, man? What's your play?
Of course, I've been getting back into repairing phones again. I want to take that more serious because just, I don't know, you ever have times where you like think too hard about stuff and then, but you got something in front of you, but you don't realize it. And that's the thing that I have in front of me, you know, like it's a skill that I've learned 2 years ago. And the first year I had success with it. Of course, I didn't make I made good money for starting out, but instead of just like building up off of that momentum, kind of just backtracked. Yeah. So, you know, just today I bought some inventory, just gonna keep on building on that and get to promoting and advertising it, letting people know what I do. So
I wanna see a lot more of that. This is actually a full function barbershop. Mm-hmm. We're in the heart of the city. Things like that gonna happen all the time. But we have to go somewhere else to get phone fixed because we don't know anybody in that backyard. But now here it is, you got it. I need to make sure that when you come here that I can always say they can identify with the service that you have.
Yeah.
You're a provider of services, you know?
Yeah. That's one thing I've always learned is just like, you know, if you could, like I've been seeing like on Instagram and stuff just from like different people, it's like if you could help people, you know, you could pretend you could make money from it, you know?
That's right.
And I just get a satisfaction too. I just like helping people. It's there like, you know, it's like, hey, your phone's messed up and I'm the one to fix it and you're super appreciative about it. Mm-hmm. Not a lot of things better than that, you know, and people appreciate your work as you would know.
You get way more responses and more support from people that you've helped in the past.
Mm-hmm.
And see that you're not wanting anything back, right?
Because
people love you to do that. Especially now, you got a skill set, man. They're paying big dollars for that. Fixed phone.
Yeah.
But that fixed phone could transform to something else. Different relationship, different opportunity, different avenue for you.
Yeah, so definitely I want to double down on that. So just about taking the steps forward, you know? So, like, it's really what just life is all about. It's like, you want to do something, just got to do it, you know? And you learn, we just got to learn along the way. Like, content-wise, I've been doing a little bit more, like, conversation style, like, kind of how me and you are doing right now. I've been doing more of those. This would be my third one I did. I did one with my friend and then another one with my family friends. Not talking about, like, you know, the BS and, like, men and women and all that, but, like, actually having, like, constructive conversations about, you know, relationships, just life in general, you know.
Keep it organic, man.
Yeah, exactly.
No premise, no plot. Let's just talk about what's going on right now.
Yeah, so. And I've been getting some pretty good, like, some good results from it, you know, so something I want to stick to. And then I'm always open to having people just to talk to, just whatever, about whatever,
right.
You know, so I think that's something I want to start developing or bringing into my content. And then, going back to repairing phones, I want to incorporate that into my content as well. Just like I can make like TikToks, like before and after videos, do like YouTube shorts of like me doing like a speeded up process of me fixing the phone, things like that. So
I'm trying to get involved in it myself, man.
Yeah.
Working on doing a new website. I need a new website, man.
Oh, yeah.
One day I wish you had a date, 3 days, to follow me at the gym, great content, and I'll keep going back and forth.
Yeah.
Then you feel me? One whole day. Yeah, no, no. And I want them to see me in a different light.
Yeah.
Different behind the chair. Show how I entertain my clients, how to get clients, Bill Bonds relationship from all coming from this project.
Anytime you provide a service, it's like, you know, especially with you, you're building a relationship every time someone sits in this chair, you know, I talk to them. You know, you want to have a bit more of a personal relationship, because then that translate, you know, people talk good about you. And then they may refer more people to you just off the strength of.
That's how I go, man.
You know?
That's how I go. You know, I had 3 NFL players. It's more than all came from one NFL player that I deal with, Cher Love. 2012, Ohio State Championship team, Dennis Smith. Alton Jefferson, Seattle Seahawks. You guys come in, they rock with me, man.
Yeah.
It says a whole lot, bro. I appreciate it, man.
Yeah. It's good, you know. Relationships are everything, you know. I know it sounds cliche, but it's not about what you know, but who you know sometimes, you know.
Listen, in that line of work.
Yeah, because it's just like the right person could just help you out tremendously. So what is your, how would you say, like, how you focus on building relationships? Like with your clients or just people in general, like you just try to just be your authentic self, and then if they rock with you, they rock with you.
I gotta be that because, of course, it's gonna be rocking things.
True.
Because if I know that you're a certain way, your lifestyle don't match mine, you don't know the things I'm about. Like, I'm a father first, man.
Yeah.
So if I know you got kids, I haven't heard you say anything about your child, anything in the month I've been around you haven't said anything. Don't invite me to go anywhere because I'm not about what I'm about.
Yeah.
So I haven't heard you say that your kids have made you excited to do anything that you're excited about. You know, why deal with that?
Yeah.
Because if something happens, you get stuck out. They're about the next turn up. I ain't about this turn up.
Yeah. It's a different phase, you know? It's just a different phase.
I've evolved for real, man. I'm a whole grown man right now, man.
Yeah. It's not your priority anymore.
It's the right watch. It's the right watch.
It ain't the right watch. It's the right watch. I think that's the first time I heard that one.
No different from a watch that costs you $50, you know, watch costs you $3,000. They both would do the same thing until time.
True. Do you think your children have given you more of a purpose for what you do?
Absolutely. You're going to experience this in one day. God bless you. You have a healthy child, 10 toes, 10 fingers, 2 hours, 2 years, all that. But the key thing is, when you have a child, man, your life goes overdrive.
Yeah.
Ain't no more sick days because you feel like you got to go get it. If you're the right type of man, you're going to tie your belt up and you're going to go grind. You're going to feel 100% what I'm saying to you right now. It's going to resonate there. So feel like no other, man. Me having a kid was the best thing that could have happened to me. Mm-hmm. Taught me to not being selfish. Taught me how to be a provider. Make me even more hungry. Not to keep no finances. So the doors were closed in my face. Opportunities I thought I had, been rock bottom. But I'm still here. Mm-hmm. You know, to do better, bigger things since then.
Yeah.
I won't change
a thing. That's good. And that's the main thing, is like, you know, not to have regrets in this life, you know?
Sure, man. Jay said it a long time, you can't live with regrets, bro.
Can't live with them. Because I hear that a lot, like, especially from, like men that have kids. It's just like, you know, it gives them more of a reason why. Even if they didn't have a reason before, it's like now they got a reason, so.
Yeah, man, especially the way I came up, the day I grew up hard, man. Part of the joy of it. So my thing was, I made sure that when I have a kid, I was going to love as hard as I could. Put all my energy and time into that. And devote myself into my craft. Find my purpose in life. People think the purpose in life is making a lot of money. It ain't always about that, man.
Yeah.
You make a decent amount of money and have a good lifestyle. But if you have a quality life to sustain, take care of your family, and you still don't have any needs.
Yeah. Like you said, I feel like I'll have one of those days too. And, you
absolutely,
know,
man. You can put your hand on that. But yeah. I tell you, you're gonna make $100 million. That's far fetched. But something that you can do to be a good person, a good part of life, you can have that tomorrow.
Yeah. You know, and you never know. It's like, you know, the success comes with, like you said, like being a good person, being a quality person, because you'll be able to build those relationships.
Yeah.
And then, you know, people they know that you're genuine and the type of person you are. So. You know, when you're a good person, it's just, I don't know, people just want to help you, they want to talk to you, they want to do, they just want to know you, be with you, you know, be seen with you.
Pay attention to somebody who's running, just doing something negative. People don't run to that. Mm-hmm. They run to the good person.
Yeah.
They have big city, brings excitement. The negative people, they frown and have a certain energy.
Yeah.
I don't want to have that vibe. I don't like that type of issue.
Nah.
I mean, my energy be organic and be happy. When I come in, I want the room light up. They're gonna put the legs in the field to be running. Especially what you're talking about, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's the energy you always do with the jet.
Definitely.
Like, for example, you see certain people in your life today, that you reconnect with certain relationships, certain friendships, and you see them today, first thing they do is probably smile and see.
Yeah.
Off an old memory. But they still remember how good you was back then, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely.
That's good, man. That means you left an everlasting.
An impression, you know? Sure. That's what it's like. That's why it's always good to be nice to everybody, you know? Mm-hmm. And I know sometimes, like, there may be a stigma about certain people just because, you know, especially, like, when we were younger, like, in school, like, certain you couldn't do this or you couldn't hang out with these people, couldn't hang out with these people.
Right.
But, you know, you should still be nice to everyone because it's like, you never know what anybody could turn out to be, you know, so.
And it's free.
Yeah.
And it's free.
Kindness is free. And then it's like, what's the point of being mean, like, bad-spirited? You know, it's just like, I feel like it takes a lot of energy to be a negative person than it does to be just a positive person.
I'll tell you why. Be mean, then ask for help. You see what happens. True. That's going to teach you a lesson right there. Be True. Mean, then ask for help. You want to get the help you need. You might deserve the help. You know what
Yeah.
Who wants to help a mean guy?
I don't know too many people that'll take that.
You know what I'm saying?
I promise y'all, every time I get in this chair, I already know I'm finna look like a whole new man. Feel good, look good, play good.
All right. Turn back on the right.
Can you hook it up to put the conditioner in my hair? Wow, that's dope. That's congratulations on that, man.
I'm so thankful for it, man.
That's big time.
You can't let my boy be a part of my journey too well. Put him in part of it.
Yeah. You never know. It's like everybody, we all have insight, you know? They may have, probably have some good stuff to bring to the table.
That's it, man. Thank you that you chose me, man. So, that's even work.
Yeah. And, you know, that's going to bring a lot more people to the shop.
The way you spinning 360s. That's what your barbershop doing, but look at this blade. Brain's blown out.
Was it for him? Wouldn't be possible.
Nah, you got good gray hair, man. It's all him.
I try. Make sure y'all take care of yourselves, guys. Especially by fellas. Take care of yourselves. Get y'all haircuts. Take care of your skin. Stay in the gym. All that good stuff.